Welcome to New Horizon Vineyard's Good Friday Worship Experience. Station 7, Our Cross. I will be reading from Luke 9, 23-24. It will be helpful to have several pieces of paper and something to write with. This is a guided experience between you and God. He has an invitation for you. If anyone would come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. For whoever wants to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for me will save it. Following Jesus is not about better, faster, stronger, higher. It is about daily doing what is required of us, whether that leads along highways of recognition and glory, or valleys of obscurity and servitude. When we desperately cling to our own agenda, we inevitably miss God's. As we surrender to Him, we find ourselves led to a better, more fulfilling life. Jesus showed us that things are upside down in His kingdom. The first are last. The greatest are the servants. We give and find that we're receiving. The paradox that outshines them all is one He most graphically demonstrated. We take up our cross daily and live. As I read the following questions, listen as God reveals the obstructions and sins that are keeping you from experience the fullness of Christ in your life. Write those things down. Confess those sins to God. As I nail my sins to the cross, tear or destroy your own paper as a reminder of God's grace and mercy for you. What does taking up your cross look like in your life? What self-directed activities and personal preoccupations are keeping you from living fully for Him? What are you afraid to surrender? What sins are you holding on to? Whatever they are, let them go. They're holding you back. Jesus, help me to die to the things I think will satisfy me, but won't. Teach me to rely on you alone. Help me let go of my need to be seen, to be valued, to have people like me. I am willing to accept the cost of following you. Father, you sent your Son to shoulder my cross. I thank you for rescuing me through His sacrifice. Because of your forgiveness and mercy, I will never be separated from your love. Father, I receive your forgiveness. I gratefully declare that I too have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. The life I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and delivered Himself up for me. So be it. Amen.